Ancient Judah was very familiar with eunuchs in society. They did come in direct contact with this group of people, enough so that both Jesus and the prophets addressed their plight and salvation. The term eunuch was given to both boys and men that had been castrated. The modern medical term for this is orchiectomy, which is the surgical removal of one or both testes. There were also children that were born with this medical condition, that is, with no testes. Several pagan kingdoms, in Egypt, Persia, Ethiopia, China, and other societies practicing idolatry, were notorious for buying and enslaving these children. Many children were sold by their parents as a way to ensure the child's life, with any funds received aiding the survival of their families. In the most severely affected, poverty-stricken areas, or to survive droughts and famines, men sold their male children into slavery and servitude knowing they would be emasculated. Some were servants to the priests in pagan temples, but more often they were forced to serve in royal courts to fulfill the debauchery of royalty. Others became chamberlains to the king, also serving the women's quarters, which included the harems and concubines. Adult eunuchs are spoken of often in the Book of Esther. Queen Esther was a Jewish woman that became the wife of the Persian king Ahasuerus. Documentation of their presence confirms eunuchs could rise to positions of power and influence within the kingdom, and were often trusted to convey messages between men and women. God's warning through the prophet Isaiah. After King Hezekiah of Judah allowed emissaries from Babylon to see all of his earthly treasures, the prophet Isaiah warned him. 2 Kings, chapter 20, verses 16 to 18.
Then Isaiah said to Hezekiah, "Hear the word of the Lord. Behold, the days are coming when all that is in your house, and what your fathers have accumulated until this day, shall be carried to Babylon. Nothing shall be left, says the Lord. And they shall take away some of your sons who will descend from you, whom you will beget. And they shall be eunuchs in the palace of the king of Babylon."
In Judaism, the castration of males, both human and animal, and the intentional impairment of male reproductive organs was strictly forbidden. Eunuchs, although acknowledged, were not to serve or enter the Jewish temples. The ban included eunuchs serving as judges and synagogue officials. That being said, eunuchs were not totally ostracized from society. Their roles ranged from craftsmen, to military guards, to palace servants and advisors. They were often seen as symbols of power and authority in pagan culture. The compassion of God is clearly extended to the eunuch in Isaiah, chapter 56, verses 4 to 5.
"For thus says the Lord, to the eunuchs who keep my Sabbaths, and choose what pleases me, and hold fast my covenant, even to them I will give in my house and within my walls a place and a name better than that of sons and daughters. I will give them an everlasting name that shall not be cut off."
There are over 35 references to eunuchs in the Bible. From the prophets, to Queen Esther, to Daniel and our Lord Jesus Christ. While Jesus addressed the issue of marriage and divorce with the Pharisees, he also taught his disciples on celibacy and brought to their attention the plight of the eunuch. Matthew chapter 19, verses 11 to 12.
"But he said to them, all cannot accept this saying, but only those to whom it has been given. For there are eunuchs who were born thus from their mother's womb, and there are eunuchs who were made eunuchs by men, and there are eunuchs who have made themselves eunuchs for the kingdom of heaven's sake. He who is able to accept it, let him accept it."
It does not go unnoticed that the scripture immediately following these verses pertains to children. Jesus blesses the children. Matthew chapter 19, verses 13 to 15.
"Then little children were brought to him that he might put his hands on them and pray, but the disciples rebuked them. But Jesus said, let the little children come to me, and do not forbid them, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. and he laid his hands on them and departed from there.
We are clearly taught that the spreading of the Word of God and belief in Jesus Christ is not limited to intact men. Philip baptizes the eunuch of Candace, the queen of the Ethiopians. Acts chapter 8, verses 30 to 38.
So Philip ran to him and heard him reading the prophet Isaiah and said, "Do you understand what you are reading?" And he said, "How can I, unless someone guides me?" And he asked Philip to come up and sit with him. The place in the scripture which he read was this: "He was led as a sheep to the slaughter, and as a lamb before its shear is silent, so he opened not his mouth. In his humiliation his justice was taken away, and who will declare his generation? For his life is taken from the earth." So the eunuch answered Philip and said, "I ask you, of whom does the prophet say this, of himself or of some other man?" Then Philip opened his mouth, and beginning at this scripture, preached Jesus to him. Now as they went down the road, they came to some water. And the eunuch said, "See, here is water. What hinders me from being baptized?" Then Philip said, "If you believe with all your heart, you may." And he answered and said, "I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God." So he commanded the chariot to stand still. And both Philip and the eunuch went down into the water, and he baptized him.
Thank you for watching Modern Bible Study Stories. Have a blessed week.